The following is a presentation of the Eagles Sports Network.
Back on the Domino's postgame report is Carson Newman downs Anderson 112-81 inside of Holt Fieldhouse. Adam Cavalier alongside Hedman's basketball coach Chuck Benson. Chuck, six players finishing double figures, but a fourth career triple-double for Charles Clark. 19 points, 10 rebounds, 10 assists, and the return of your assistant head coach.
He's back.
Little Jakey Benson.
He's back.
Let's focus on Charles's triple-double. We've seen it before, but what made this one different from the first three?
He sort of, we didn't really know that was – it seemed like he was having a stat sheet stuffing kind of game, but till the very end, I didn't really know he even had the thing till late there. And I'm just glad he got it, obviously – he and I were talking about it before the game. His time here is getting short, with tonight in mind. I mean, he's got this, made five remaining games in Holt Fieldhouse, and he's been such an incredible player here, and he just wants to maximize every opportunity we get up here. And we knew coming in, Anderson would be very, very tough, and they're playing much better than they did the first time we played him earlier in the year. And so thankfully he brought it, and other guys brought it, and we were able to get the win.
68 points in the second half, and an offensive explosion, most points in a half since that bonkers game against Coker to finish the regular season here last year. What ignited the powder keg in the second stanza, especially offensively?
Well, we had a pretty significant talk at the half just about the fact that we came out and I did not like where our intensity was. I didn't like our sense of urgency. And I challenged some guys to be leaders that put forth a demonstration that would be contagious to others. And I felt like the minute we came on the floor the second half, to start that second half, there was a different sort of vibe. We were up eight at the half, but it didn't feel like that. And truthfully, I'm telling us, guys, nobody's having fun. This is not enjoyable right now. We're just going through the motions. Let's try to enjoy this thing. And I think that was sort of the you saw guys having fun. Sam, you saw guys having fun. Everybody was having fun. Watching it, playing it, coaching it, whatever.
Get some consistency out of them, especially two in the second half. Cam Holmes, first career time that he's gone back-to-back double-digit scoring efforts. Same is true for Parker Ole. Mm-hmm. What about those kind of guys that are starting to – you and I kind of chatted about it earlier this week just in the offices. Two guys that have pretty substantial consistent play in back-to-back games now.
We need that. We need consistency. That word is one that we focus on a lot because consistency leads to wins, and inconsistency leads to wins and losses. So, we want to have guys that are striving for consistency and performing at a certain level, controlling their controllables. And I'm happy to see Cameron Parker both did that tonight, and they were critical pieces in the fact that we're able to get that win tonight.
Nearly had eight guys in double figures. Finished with six. Seven would have been a school record. What is it about this team that leads to that level of scoring balance?
Well, I think we've got several guys that are talented enough to make baskets. And we share it. We share the basketball. 29 assists tonight. The ball is moving. It's not sticking. Guys are making the right decisions, the right choice, and then capitalizing. And it's that simple, but it's harder to do than I make.
Grant Teichman matches his career high with 17 points, not to mention nine assists. What about the job that he did tonight?
Well, I was happy for Grant. His dad was in the building. His brother was in the building, who actually is a college coach himself down in Florida, and came in and was able to visit with us tonight. They're playing up here in the woods. So we had family here, and I was glad I had a chance to demonstrate, and our team got to make a performance with them being in the gym.
Anderson's Randall Shaw, 14 points, but you limit his efficiency. 2 of 13 from the field, 2 of 9 from 3. Christian Jeffords knocked down 5 threes late when there wasn't game pressure on anymore. Yeah. How do you sum up the defensive effort tonight against the Trojans?
Well, like you said, I thought we got distance separation from them early in that second half. And then late in the second half, like you said, when the game pressure was off and there, there really wasn't a chance for them to win. And then they just were just hooping. So you know, our numbers are a little distorted. Our percentages are a little distorted based on that. But all in all, especially the second half, I was pleased with that combination of defense and scoring punch, and that allowed us to get that scoreboard separation we so desperately needed.
How do you utilize this moving forward? You head to a pretty tough place to play in Shuford Memorial Gym in Hickory, North Carolina, against the LR Bears on Saturday.
Well, you know, and you know this, we've had our own struggles down there. For whatever reason, that's been a place where we've not won a lot. We beat them here earlier this year, but that was after being down 17 at one point and found a way to win. Hopefully, though, we'll go in with a lot of confidence and can go in and figure out some kind of strategy that allows us to get stops, make shots, and come away with another win.
And you've got another coach moving in here.
Do you want to – what do you – you want to say something here, man?
Let's wrap this up with Coop Dog.
Yeah, we had – he's the junior assistant, so he's ready.
I got to call you out on something, though. You told me Saturday. No more ties, and here you are.
I actually forgot the commitment we made. I forgot the commitment. Now that you bring it up, yeah, we actually discussed that. So
shame on you. All right, Chuck, pleasure as always. Congrats on the win.
Thanks, Kev.
That is Carson Newman, head men's basketball coach, Chuck Benson.